Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Assalamu alaikum. Dear students, this is Tariq Amin, lecturer, Department of English, Kohat University of Science and Technology, Kohat. Our today's topic is Reading Comprehension Technique, SQ3R. This is the 15th lecture of the course, Study Skills. The course code is ENG123. Lecture outlines of today's class include reading comprehension. First of all, we will try to understand what is reading comprehension. After that, we will discuss the reading comprehension technique that is called SQ3R, survey, question, read, recite, and then review. S stands for survey, Q stands for question, and 3R stands for read, write, and review. Learning objectives. The students will be able to know about reading comprehension, and they will also be able to understand the SQ3R technique of reading comprehension, and they will be able to understand how to apply this technique. SQ3R is a reading study, reading technique, or it is a reading method. In other words, we say that it is a study technique or a study method designed to help process and increase retention of written information. So it is a reading technique or reading method that helps us process information or process written information, and a part of helping us process written information, it also helps us increase retention of the written information. First of all, it helps us process written information, and after that, it helps us increase retention of such written information in our long-term memory. The SQ3R method is a proven method. It is a proven method for getting more out of reading your textbook. So it is proved that this is the most helpful technique with the help of which you can get more and more out of your textbook, more and more out of your text that you are reading. So it is a proven method. It can help you out, get more and more out of a particular text. SQ3R stands for S stands for survey, Q stands for question, R stands for read, R stands for recite, and R stands for review. These three are, this S stands for survey, the second letter that is Q stands for question, and 3R means this is 1R, 2R, 3R. These are three different R. That is why it is called 3R. SQ3R. SQ3R consists of the following five steps. The first one is survey. First of all, when you read, try to read a text, first of all, you need to survey it. Survey the text to get the main ideas. First of all, you need to survey a particular text in order to guess the main ideas that are there in the text. When you survey a text, you need to look for titles and headings. First of all, you need to look at titles. Titles are most of the time the shortest possible summaries of the text. When you look at the title of a particular text, you come to know about the general ideas or the main ideas of that very text. And headings and different titles are in different topics. We have different headings and subheadings, and these headings and subheading and titles helps us indicate the main topics and concepts that are being developed in a text. So you need to look for titles and headings, and after that, after looking at titles and headings, we need to focus on pictures, questions, bold and italicized print. And what is the function of writing something in bold or italicizing something? Its function is to emphasize important information. If you want to emphasize important information in a text, you can italicize that information, or you can write them in bold. So they emphasize important information. Introduction and conclusion. Introduction part of a text helps us introduce a topic. When you read introduction part of a text, you come to know about the different ideas that are there in the text, or there are the different ideas that have been discussed in the text. And in conclusion, we can find concluding sentences, concluding statements. They may give the topics being covered as well as the purpose. First and last sentences and paragraphs are very much important. First, most of the time, first sentence of a paragraph is topic sentence or topical sentence. And topic sentence is a sentence that states the central idea of a paragraph. Most of the time, we find topic sentence at the very beginning of a paragraph, but it is not always the case that we would always find the topic sentence of a paragraph at the very beginning of that paragraph. Sometimes we find cases, we come across paragraphs where we don't find topic sentence at the beginning of a paragraph. In such cases, we find questions, we find quotations, and we find anecdote at the beginning of this paragraph. And these are these different these different paragraph questions, these quotations, and these anecdotes can be called attention grab, because they grab the attention of the readers. And last sentences are also important, because most of the time last sentences are concluding sentences or closing sentences. They conclude the central ideas of the paragraphs. So we need to focus upon first sentences and last sentences. We need to focus upon introduction. We need to focus upon conclusion, because these are the most important parts of a text. And titles and headings are also important. We find different headings and subheadings, and there are always some links between headings and subheadings in titles. And we need to focus upon the different relationships that are there in these different headings and subheadings and titles. And we need to focus upon pictures as well, because pictures are very much important, and we can get lots of meaning, and we can derive lots of meaning from pictures. Questions are also important. Bold. If something is written in bold or something has been italicized, it means that some important information is there in that word and in that sentence or in that clause that has been written in bold or that has been italicized. Footnotes are also very much important. So you can read footnotes as well when you survey a text. That is how you can survey a text. First read title, then headings, then pictures, questions, and the different words or phrases that have been written in bold or that have been italicized. And after that, focus upon introduction and conclusion. And you can also focus upon the first and last sentences of the remaining paragraph. And at the end, read footnotes. The next step is question. After surveying a text, you need to ask different questions. Write questions to give purpose and improve concentration. And if you want to improve your concentration, you need to ask different questions. The more questions you ask, the more you will be concentrated. So you can improve your concentration with the help of different questions. After surveying a text or during surveying a text, ask different questions, write different questions. This adds comprehension. If you ask different questions, it will help you comprehend a text. Turn main headings and pictures into questions. As I've discussed in the previous slide, that we see different pictures and we see different titles and headings. titles and headings in different texts. You need to turn main headings, pictures and titles into questions. That is how you can ask different questions, you can make different questions. So you need to turn headings into questions. Jot down questions that you may have as you survey the material. When you survey a particular material, you need to write different questions. So jot down your question when you are surveying a text. You may add further questions as you proceed. It is not that first of all you need to ask questions and after that you cannot ask questions. It is not the case. You can ask more and more questions as you proceed. You can ask questions at the beginning, you can ask questions at the middle, and you can ask questions at the very end of your reading, in the end of your text. Okay, now let's come to the different three R's. The first R is read. The first R stands for read. Read each section one at a time with your questions in mind. When you start reading a text, it is necessary that you should keep the different questions in your mind that you have written down with you. So you should read different sections. You should read each and every section with your own question in your mind. So always keep your question in your mind when you read each and every section. Search for answers to your questions. While you are reading, you need to search for answers to your different questions. Read with a highlighter and pencil in your hand. Highlighter and pencil are very much important. When you are reading a text, you are reading your textbook or you are reading a note that has been given to you by your teacher. When you start reading those notes, you start reading a text, you need to have a highlighter, and the second thing is you need to have your pencil in your hand. Now, what are the different functions of highlighter and pencil? We will discuss it in the next slide. That with the help of highlighter, okay, let's discuss it in this very slide. Highlighter will help you highlight the answer to your question that you have created. With the help of highlighter, you can highlight the answers to your question that you have written at the very beginning of this reading process, or the question that you have written at the middle, in the middle of your reading process. So you can highlight answers with the help of highlighter. Okay, make notes and highlight main points that support the concept, the central concept of a text. And with the help, we haven't discussed the function of pencil or the role of pencil in reading process. With the help of pencil, you can make different notes. You can make notes, and with the help of highlighter, you can highlight the answer and you can highlight the main idea that support the central idea and support the concept. The second R is recite. Reciting helps to put information into your long-term memory. There are three different types of memory. The first one is sensory memory. The second one is called STM, short-term memory. And the third one is called LTM. Sensory memory, short-term memory, and long-term memory. When you recite something or when you repeat something, it may help you put information into your long-term memory. And from your long-term memory, you can recall that information after a long period of time. You can recall that information after 1 year, 2 years, 3 years. When something becomes part of your long-term memory, you can recall it anytime. Okay, say the answers to your questions out loud. So when you are done with your reading process, you need to repeat it, you need to recite it, you need to to say your question and say your answer, or say the answer to your questions out loudly. Put what you have learned into your own words. After you are done with the reading process and you have come across the different answers to your questions as well, the next stage is to put what you have come across or what you have learned into your own words. So you need to write the different points in your own words, or you need to write the answers to your question in your own word, and you need to recite the answers to your question in your own words. Pretend like you are teaching someone else what you just read. Okay, now you have your answers. Now just pretend that you are answering, or you are teaching the same material and the same answer and the same content to others. For example, to your friends, to your friends, to your classmates, to your group members, and to your brothers and sisters. Just pretend that you are teaching the same material and the same thing, the same content to your friend, and say out loud all the things. Remember that recite means say out loud. When we say that recite the information, it means that we said it, say it out loud. So this is the second R, and the fourth process is recite. This process comes after reading process. When you are done with your reading process, now you need to repeat it again and again. You need to repeat the main points again and again. You need to recite the same point, the main point, the answers to your questions again and again, so that you may not forget it. In order to make these answers to your question are the in order to make what you have learned part of your long-term memory, LTM, you need to recite it. Okay, the last R is review. The last R stands for review. Reviewing what you learn is essential in retaining information. You have learned something, now you need to retain it. Now, how can you retain this information in order to retain the what you have learned, in order to make it part of your long-term memory, in order to retain this information for a long period of time, you need to review it again and again. Review within 24 hours of learning, you will remember 80% of it. You learn something at 8 o'clock, now you need to review it within 24 hours of this learning process. If you review it within 24 hours of this learning process, you will be able to remember 80% of what you have learned. Whereas if you don't review it within 24 hours, you will only remember 20%. Keep this in mind. This is why we say that review is very much important, and if you want to retain more and more information, you need to review your information again and again. And if you don't review within 24 hours of learning process, you will be able to remember only 20% of it. Then you just have to spend more time later relearning the information. That is why we say that review is very much important. This is very much important technique that is called SQ3R method, SQ3R technique, and it is reading comprehension technique. It helps you comprehend a text easily. It helps you make information part of your long-term memory. It helps you retain information for a long period of time. Okay, these are some of the references. You can download different PDF files. This is the first file that I have mentioned over here, is PDF file. You can download it. And the second file is also PDF, you can download it as well. So in today's class we discuss reading comprehension technique, that is SQ3R. S stands for survey, Q stands for question, and the 3R stands for read, recite, and review and survey. We discussed that first of all you need to survey a text. You can survey a text by looking at its title, headings, pictures, questions, something that has been written in bold or something that has been italicized. And you can survey a text by looking at its introduction part, introductory part, or concluding part or conclusion. So first of all you need to survey a text before you read it. And the second stage here, the second step in SQ3R method is question. When you survey a text, you need to write down different questions with yourself. You can ask questions at the beginning, in the middle, and at the end. The third point is, after you have written down different questions, the third step is to now read the text. Now, when you read a text, you try to look for the answers to your questions. You need to highlight important points. You need to highlight answers to your questions. And you need to make notes, and you should have highlighter and a pen or a pencil in your hand. And after you are done with this reading, hectic reading point, reading process, you need to recite it. Recite means say out loud. You need to repeat and you need to recite the same information in your own words. The last step is review. Now you need, after you recite the information, you say the same information, you write the same information, the same content in your own words, the next step is to review it within 24 hours of learning it. If you review it within 24 hours of learning it, you will be able to remember 80% of it. And on the other hand, if you don't review this, review what you have learned within 24 hours of this learning process, you would be able to retain just 10% of your information, 10% of what you have learned. Thank you very much for listening to the lecture, and if you have any question, you can ask questions. Thank you very much for listening to the lecture. Allah Hafiz.